I'm Laura Blanton. I'm an educator here at the National Air and Space Museum. November 2020 marked 20 years of continuous human presence on the International Space Station. On November 2nd, 2000, Bill Shepard, Yuri Gudzinko, and Sergei Krylov became the first crew to live and work in space. Since then, over 240 astronauts from 19 different countries have visited the ISS. So, what is it like to live and work in space? NASA astronauts living on the ISS have shared their experiences through a variety of methods, through interviews, photography, and journal entries. Primary sources such as these enable students to build a stronger understanding of historical concepts, consider subjectivity in historical accounts, and form connections with people living throughout history. In the National Air and Space Museum archives, we have several different collections of astronaut papers. One of those is the Sally Ride Papers collection. In 1983, Sally Ride became the first American woman to fly in space. Her papers include a vast array of materials, from training resources and notes, to letter exchanges with female Russian cosmonauts, to annotated pictures, to papers documenting her career after serving as an astronaut. Through records like these, students can gain a better understanding of astronaut life, creating opportunities to understand different perspectives and experiences. NASA has a repository of various astronaut journals on their website, entries covering an array of experiences unique to space travel, such as living in a microgravity environment and those we experience here on Earth, such as celebrating holidays and eating meals. So, why do astronauts complete journal entries? These journals are a source of a NASA study called the Behavior Issues Associated with Isolation and Confinement, Review and Analysis of Astronaut Journals, or just Journal Study for short. Astronaut journals provide information on experiences in space, as well as the mental and emotional well-being of astronauts. Experiences we can learn about from these sources include what it's like to work in a new environment, isolation, and the overview effect. Or space travel as an experience that changes your attitude towards Earth and what it means to be human. Now in its second phase, the journal study illustrates a fuller picture of risks and mitigation factors in astronaut isolation and containment while in space in order to better prepare astronauts for longer future space missions. Journaling can also be a helpful mode of reflection. One astronaut wrote in their journal that, "I realized that oftentimes I use this journal to vent my frustrations. This helps me to collect my composure and to deal with the situations. I must continue to look at the big picture and count myself lucky to be here." Reflection can also be a useful tool for students to deepen understanding. According to John Dewey, reflection serves as a tool to enable people to move from reactive to more thoughtful, evidence-based modes. Reflection can also be a way to further develop understanding and thinking dispositions, such as making observations, building connections, and considering other perspectives. Reflection through journaling can serve as a form of documentation, which is defined by Ron Richert in Making Thinking Visible as the practice of observing, recording, interpreting, and sharing through a variety of media, the processes and products of teaching and learning in order to deepen learning. Thus, journaling can shed light on student thinking and understanding around a topic. So, what shared experiences might students find in space travel? We've gathered several readings from journals available through NASA's website to provoke thoughtful reflection on astronaut perspectives and experiences in space. Structure students' reflection through a prompt in order to elicit meaning-making or to better understand various perspectives. One possible prompt is to use a Harvard Project Zero thinking routine, such as step in, step out, step back, for perspective taking, or the three whys for connection building. Another journaling prompt idea is to ask students to respond by connecting astronaut experiences to their own. For example, if an astronaut wrote about isolating experiences, students could connect by writing about their time in isolation within the COVID-19 pandemic. Links to selected journals, thinking routines, and videos of astronauts sharing their experiences are included in the lesson plans corresponding to this video. There are plenty of tools available to build engaging digital journals. Two possible options are to use Google Slides or Adobe Spark. Google Slides is an easy way for students to keep a digital journal with multiple entries. The title slide can be a fun introduction to a student's journal, with the next slide serving as a table of contents. The following slides can serve as individual journal entries. If there are multiple entries, you can even link slides to their corresponding entries in the table of contents. If your school has an Adobe Spark membership, Spark Video is a way that students can record their own audio reflection, use pictures, and even incorporate text. We hope these tips are helpful to you and your students as you go forth and journal.